Miss Erica's car?
Yes, it is, sir.
Are you a friend of hers?
Oh, yes, she's inside.
What, and left you out here? I never heard such a thing.
Oh, she said she wouldn't be long.
Oh, yes, she will. It's Felicity's birthday party.
Felicity?
My little daughter. She's 7 today.
Oh, yes, of course. Felicity's birthday. Yeah. I was forgetting.
She always brings over a present. Hasn't missed a year.
Really?
No, not a year. There was something radically wrong. She forgot her birthday.
Oh, quite.
Well, come along in.
No, I better not.
Nonsense. I can't leave you out here like a criminal. Come along.
It'll be great fun. I'm sure it will.
Erica, my dear, this is a nice state of affairs. You bring a young man, then leave him outside.
I only meant to stay a few minutes, Uncle.
Oh, nonsense. You must stay here and see the party go with a swing.
Erica, we must get away. Every minute's important.
It's this frightful party. I'm having an awful job.
Yes, I know. You've been so good. I'm so grateful I could.
Come in, dear.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Hello, my dear. Do you know what Erica did? Left her friend outside while she was romping with the children.
Really? I'm very sorry. I honestly only meant to stay a few minutes. I came because I wanted
to... You came to bring Felicity her birthday present, didn't you?
Oh, that is sweet of you, Erica. One of those lovely little stone dwarfs for the garden. Isn't it nice? It's exactly like the ones we've got. It'll fit in so nicely.
Should we join the others?
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, darling.
Oh, Erica, do let's play Find the Thimble.
Please. Hello, Felicity. Are you having a nice time?
Yes, thank you, Erica, but I want to play Find the Thimble.
Well, I expect you can if you ask Mummy.
I mean, I want you to play it.
I can't just now, dear. I will presently.
But why can't you play it now?
Come on, we'll play it on our own.
Major Cunningham, Mrs. Cunningham.
Sit by me. Basil, get the crackers, please.
Oh, yes, yes, of course.
I suppose you're staying with the Burgoynes, Mr.
No, not exactly, quite near.
Such a large family. I never remember how many there are. I suppose you find that rather difficult.
Yes, I'm not too sure myself.
Erica, I'm so sorry. I didn't quite catch your friend's name.
Beechcroft Manningtree.
Oh, really?
That's an extraordinary name, isn't it?
I don't think I've ever come across it before.
Come along, Erica.
Oh,
let's go now.
We can't. They'll start thinking things.
I started thinking things long ago.
Be quiet.
Love calls but once, though passion oft. Oh.
I say, steady, old girl.
I'll read it out.
You must leave things like that to me, Harold.
It was my motto.
Ah, the ice is
good. In the nick of time.
We really ought to be going.
Yes, I really think we should.
Yes, yes, of course. Would you mind taking these ices for me, please?
Oh, certainly, of course. Are these strawberry?
Yes, the red strawberry and the white's vanilla, you see.
Fancy.
What a nice young man that is, Erica. Has your father known him long?
Oh, not very.
What does he do for a living?
A sort of clerk, I believe.
Oh, in what?
Advertising. He makes up advertisements.
What a very uncommon name. What did you say? Yes.
A Beechtree Manningcroft.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Would you just take those ices to those nurses over there for me? What a very sweet girl Erica is. Don't you think so, Mr. Croft?
Yes, awfully nice.
Have you known Colonel Burgoyne long?
Oh, yes, years and years.
Your work must be very interesting.
My work?
Yes, Erica's just been talking to me about it.
Oh, yes, of course.
Do you like it? So many young men of today dislike their work.
Oh, I love it. I find it very satisfying.
It must be awfully difficult to strike the right note.
At first, perhaps. Oh, of course, you need a good ear.
Ear? Yeah. I should have thought an eye would be much more important.
Yes, that's important, certainly. But I can read at sight now.
Beg your pardon?
I mean, I can sing a piece of music if it's put in front of me.
Sing?
And play, of course.
Oh, yes, of course.
I'll tell her definitely we're going. Auntie, I've got rid of those ices. Now, we really should be going.
Very well, my dear. It was nice of you to come. It's a pity you have to go so soon. I've had such an interesting talk with your friend, Mr. Manningcroft.
We want another game, Mother.
Oh, let's get the ices served first. Just wait till the children go. Well, one more. What should it be?
Harold wants Blind Man's Buff.
I'll be
be blind man.
That's for me to decide, Harold.
Mother's would prefer blind man, eh, Felicity?
Tie up, Uncle.
I don't think so, dear.
Oh, do, and then you can try and catch me.
Oh, very well. Mr. Beechtree. Oh, where's Erica?
They've gone home. They asked me to say goodbye.
You idiot. Didn't you realize there was something going on between them? She didn't know his name. He didn't know it himself even, really.
Oh, you're exaggerating.
Nothing of the sort. I wanted to find out more about them. If you hadn't made me play blind man's buff. There you are, Basil. What did I tell you? They've not gone home. They've taken the other direction. Keenthorpe, 843, please. Hurry.
Oh, why, hello, Margaret.
Thought we should never get away.
Didn't you think she seemed a bit suspicious?
I don't think so. Just naturally inquisitive. She seemed satisfied with the answers I gave.
I nearly died when you produced that china dwarf.
I wonder if she'll ever miss it from the garden.
We mustn't laugh.
Why not? It was very funny when she asked my name.
I was scared stiff.
The look on your face.
No, we mustn't laugh. It's very serious.
All the same, you look much better when you're laughing.
Do I?
Of course, I don't want to make trouble. I feel it's my duty to tell you. I mean, Erica's so young, she's at an awkward age.
Oh, but I can't understand it. Erica always tells me if she's going a long way. And certainly who she's going with. Well, Gordon Bleem is the only man I don't like to see her with.
Well, then it was him. I'm sure of it. He gave a false name.
Yes, but he's in India.
Oh, then it wasn't him.
Which way did you see the car went? Yes. Yes. All right, I'll phone you later.
He never even thanked me.
2 more miles and we'll be there. 2 more miles and we'll be there.
Yes, we'll be there. What then?
What then, my child? What then? The tramp, the coat, the belt back to Daddy Edie's
palace. Are you sure the tramp will be there?
Of course he will. He'll be standing on the doorstep, tears streaming down his simple face, saying, here you are, Governor.
Will it be as easy as all that?
Why not? Everything's gone all right up till now. I don't see why our luck should change.
I hope not. It'll be such a waste.
When you get back to your father, you can burst open the door and say...
With a throb in my voice.
Yes, a throb in the voice is certainly indicated. You will stand in front of him and say, I've travelled far and risked much. And here is the man in all his innocence.
Then he'll pat me on the head and say...
With a throb in his voice.
Thank you, Erica. Thank you.
You're rather touching if you knelt, I think.
Oh, Robert, if only things will turn out all right.
They started to.
Well, how do you mean?
You called me Robert.
Oh, did I? I didn't notice it.
She'll be going through Lemming unless she turns back. Well, it's an old Morris. No, I don't remember the number. She'll have someone with her. A young man, I believe. Get her to telephone me, will you?
Excuse me, are you Miss Burgoyne?
Yes.
Your father's chief constable, isn't he?
Yes, why?
He wants you to phone him right away.
Oh.
Says it's urgent. Will you step inside? Why, you're the chap who escaped from the police court this morning. I've seen your picture. Here, you better come inside here.
Quick, step on it!
We're overconfident. We ought to give him this place a miss. Still, we may do it. Just the best you can get out of her. God, we seem to be crawling.
It's awful running away like this, especially with an escaped man. It means I'm an accessory, I'll get 10 years. Oh, it's terrible. What'll happen to the boys, poor father? We must go faster, faster. You've got to get that coat back. I can't go back now. Oh, poor father, what shall I tell him? What shall I tell him?
Well, I suppose it must be the men. I can't understand it. Keep my daughter's name out of it, Inspector. Well, for the time, anyway.
That's all right, sir. Don't you worry. The search is well underway. He's probably forced her to go to Ashcroft Forest. There'd be less chance of them being found there. We're combing the forest now, sir.
Mm-hmm.
It's all right, my dear. We're perfectly safe here. We'll hide here for a bit. The whole thing will be over in a couple of hours or so. We can shake hands and you'll never see me again.
Won't I?
Well, you needn't ever see me again. Put your camera.
It's all right, Red.
Now you do as I tell you. I know exactly how you feel. You'll see no end, can you? You don't believe it's true. The night always exaggerates things, doesn't it? Personally, I like the night. It's much more alive than the day. Look at those people in that train. Eating. Actually eating. I tell you what, I'll scout about for something to eat, shall I? No, we'll wait. We'll wait till the coat's safely in our hands, and then we'll eat. And how we'll eat. Straight through a 7-course dinner, second helpings and champagne. Well, I'm going now. I shan't be long. And off we'll go and dangle the belt before their goggling eyes. And then I'll carry you all the way home.
Well, now for the lodging house. Look what I pinched from a railwoman's hut. Well, how do I look?
America. America, darling, do say something.
Can't. I just can't. I know I'm being silly, but I'm so terribly... terribly tired.
My dear, of course you are. What can I do? Perhaps you better get along home.
No. I won't see it out now.
For Martha's.
Will I be all right here? I don't want anything to happen to me.
You'll be perfectly safe, I promise you. Now, you have a little nap and try and forget all your worries. That's right.
Towser. Look after her, Towser.
I don't want anything to happen to you either.
Evening, Nobby.
All right, Nobby. He's been dead since before the war.
Oh. Got a beard?
One left.
Okay.
Number 6.
Thanks. Oh, Will in yet?
Will? No, I've kept his bed. You're a pal of his?
Yeah.
I didn't know you had one.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Good night. Thank you.
Well, cheerio, boss. See you again later. Good luck to you, Mike.
Automobile, I'm coming your way.
I don't want any of that business here, do you understand?
I don't want to come here again.
That's all right, then you keep out.
The bid bids ain't worth sweeping in.
Get out.
Oh, Will hasn't gone yet, has he?
You're his pal, you ought to know.
Just woke up. Do you know which is Old Will, the China Mender?
No, mate. Never heard of him.
So that's the game, is it? So you are a pal of his after all. How long has this racket been going on?
In a matter of
fact. Well,
who wants me? Oh, the governor. Hello, ducky. Cup want mending?
Don't you come your racket in here.
What's your trouble, Cole?
Getting your pal to bust up my china so that you can mend it.
My pal?
I don't want any argument from you. It's the last time you come in here.
What's he mean? And who are you?
Listen, I want to talk to you.
I'll answer you in a minute. It's in my wallet.
I've got to talk to you. It's about something very important.
What's your game? And who says that I'm your pal?
Oh, no, that was a mistake.
I was thinking blinking well was.
I've chased you for nearly 50 miles.
50 miles? What for?
Do you know anything about a raincoat?
I don't know what you're talking about. I've got to get along.
You do know something about it. But I'm not interested in you. I only want the coat.
Go on, Will. Bash his mug in.
You'll get something you don't expect in a minute.
You got a coat from Tom's hat, didn't you? Well, it's mine. Only want it for evidence. You can have it back afterwards.
It's no good asking me. I keep telling you I don't know nothing about it.
Oh, why are you so obstinate? I tell you it's a matter of life and death. It's going to save me. It's going to save me from a charge of murder. The police are after me now.
Hi, come here.
Murder here. I can't hang about here.
Come before you. Erica. My God, they'll find her. Come on, I'm not finished with you yet.
What's the idea? Here, wait a minute. Where
are you going? Stop it.
The police are after
him. Hurry up, Sergeant. They just run out.
Erica, Erica. Start her up, quick.
What's the idea? I don't want to get anything.
Drive that way.
Not the
coat. Yeah, the chap knows all about it. He's keeping his mouth shut.
Kidnapped.
They're coming. Come on, Townsend. What's the matter with the darn dog?
My Jesus, Els.
Coat. Look, the raincoat.
Pull up. We've got it. Know what you were up to, Governor. Coming along and saying you're my pal. Dragging me about like this. I feel like a shy bride.
I'm terribly glad. I wonder how far the nearest telephone box is. I ought to get on to Father.
There you are.
It's mine, all right. There's no belt. Now, what have you done with the belt? What have you done with that belt?
Belt?
Well, here's where it was fixed. What's happened to it?
There wasn't no belt on it when the bloke gave it me.
And it was my belt. Who'd you say gave you the coat?
I told you, some fella.
But can't you remember what it looked like?
Yes, he blinked.
What do you mean, blinked?
How do you mean?
Like it.
Anyhow, his evidence is as good as the belt. He knows that I didn't give it to him.
Oh, no, Governor, it wasn't you.
It's no good, Robert.
Of course it is. It's perfectly good proof.
The police will never believe his evidence.
What do you mean? I'm respectable.
And as for Tram saying he was given a practically new overcoat, well, they'll think it's fantastic.
I've got to talk to you more about this. The police will catch up with us soon. Where's the best place to hide?
Well, there's Brickett's Wood about 3 miles off, and there's a quiet little lane I know where nobody goes much before you get to Ebbing. Oh, what about the old mine workings? About a mile or so up.
That'll do. Come on, Erica. Let's try the old mine workings.
He's all right, they'll find him.
You're all right, you mean? I'm going back.
Don't sit, little idiot. Come on.
Hold on, miss, hold on.
Have you got him? Oh, he's got him now. Which way did he go?
Now, Miss Burgoyne, we know that your being involved in this is no fault of your own.
Really?
We naturally surmise that you were trying to trap him.
I see.
When he gave you the slip, where do you think he was making for?
I don't know.
And he said nothing at all?
Nothing at all.
Miss Burgoyne, I'm doing all I can to make things easy for you. Will you please try and make them easy for me? I've got a job on here. I've got to find a murderer.
Then why don't you?
Well, we're doing our best.
You're not. Can't you see what a mistake you're making? You find a clue, then follow it to death.
The evidence against Tisdall is very strong.
It's not. Can't you tell he didn't do it? He had no reason to. The woman was helping him. He told you that.
Yes, he told us a lot of things.
And if you'd stop chasing him, you might find the real murderer.
I should like to know why you take all this interest in Tisdall.
Because he's innocent. He couldn't kill anything. He's much too kind and gentle. Why, he's the finest person...
I'm sorry to have kept you waiting, gentlemen.
For what we're about to receive, may the Lord make us truly thankful. Christopher, try not to be so noisy with your soup.
Okay.
Your father would like to see you when you finish, Miss Erica.
Come in, Erica, my dear. I wanted us to have a little talk together. I can quite understand that you didn't want to speak in front of those detectives. But surely there's something that you want to tell me that might help us to find this fellow.
No, Father, there's nothing.
I see. You still persist in shielding a man wanted for murder.
He's not a murderer.
You know as well as I do that you're committing a criminal offense, and I'm responsible. You'd better read this.
Must you do this, Father?
You'd better go to your room. Stay there for the time being.
Oh. Is everything all right? Has old Will found him?
I'm going to give myself up. That's why I came back. I wanted to tell them that I forced you into it. To say goodbye.
I did it because I wanted to.
It's no use. The Cope and Opel was the end of everything. I suppose they found it in the car.
Yes, they brought it in while I was being questioned.
No belt in the pocket by any chance?
No. Nothing but a box of matches from the Grand Hotel.
I've got to go. Oh, Will's waiting.
Would you go now? I don't want to look around.
Did you say Grand Hotel?
Yes, why?
I've never been there in my life.
Then whoever killed...
Has been, or still is, the Grand Hotel.
It isn't Cinderella. What's the idea?
What idea?
This dressing up for the ball.
I don't know what you mean, officer.
Well, this. I've been watching you for the last half hour.
I'm so glad you came back. I don't know what I'd have done without you. After all, you're the only one that can recognize him.
These boots pinch a bit. I haven't had time to slit them for my corns. Hadn't we better start looking for him?
Yes, all right.
Here, what's that place?
That's the office.
Well, perhaps they know a bloke what twitches. I'll go and ask. Excuse me, miss. You don't happen to know...
Just a moment, please.
All right.
It's no good asking her. She'll never know a thing like that.
But what about trying in there, eh?
Yes, anywhere.
Yeah.
Yes, sir?
Table for two, please.
Thank you.
We ought to order tea or something if we're going to stay here long.
What should I have, beer?
I don't think we can get any at the moment.
I better order it as I'm the man, eh? Two cups of tea, please.
Indian or China, sir?
No, tea.
You keep an eye while I telephone her father.
Big it on.
Haven't you seen anyone with a twitch yet?
Too many people.
You must find him.
Well, I can't ask them all if they twitches, can I? Now we've bitten off more than we can chew yet.
He must be here somewhere.
Hello, Mr. Cope.
excite your dancing feet. I'm right here to tell you, mister, no one can like the drummer man. When it comes to doing tricks with a pair of hickory sticks, I'm right here to tell you, sister, no one can like the drummer man. Every man who plays in the band is wonderful too. I've got to give credit where credit is due. But when it comes to make that music up, make you give it all it's got, I'm right here to tell you, mister, no one can like the drummer man.
Just with one eye?
No, both eyes. I can't see nothing with all these people crowding about. Can't we go to another table?
We can't, they're all taken.
Well, we've got to get a look somehow. What about dancing around, eh?
Can you dance?
No, of course not, Ducky, but I don't mind having a go. It's only half walking anyway.
All right.
I wish I had my old boots.
You old man. Don't come in again like that. It isn't funny, and I pay someone else to make the orchestrations.
I'm afraid it's no good, Ducky.
We mustn't give up.
The cops have been watching us for the past quarter of an hour.
I know. I didn't think you'd noticed.
I didn't think you hadn't, neither.
They're probably looking for Mr. Tisdall.
Shouldn't take too many of those, old man.
I'll take as many as I will, please.
All right. All right.
I'm sorry. Anyway, given me to stop this twitch, it's got to be stopped somehow. It's getting on my nerves.
Come on, boys. Time's up.
I want to thank you for your patience and your consideration.
The whole thing's beyond me. You must go in.
Sorry, sir, but it can't be helped.
Yes, of course. Go ahead. Do whatever you think fit.
There's nothing you need to do. I was saying there's nothing you need do to her. It's all right. I'm not going to give any trouble.
But you didn't think of that sooner. You might have saved a great deal of trouble.
Well, bring him inside, Sergeant. I'm going to get Miss Burgoyne and the other man.
All right, boys, give us a name.
Whereabouts?
Over there.
Ask him to come out, will you?
I don't know, sir. I was trying to find a doctor. They don't seem to know what to do for him.
Oh, can't we help?
Your last efforts at first aid weren't much of a success, were they?
Can't you be human for once?
Here.
Here, let me see. Get some brandy, sir. Someone wiped the black from his face.
That's him, miss. It's him, all right.
You gave an old tramp a raincoat, didn't you? What did you do with the belt that belonged to him?
What did I do with the belt? I twisted it round her neck and choked the life out of her.
Found him. It's all right. It's all right. Don't you think we ought to ask Mr. Tisdale to dinner?